What's up, y'all? Welcome back to another video. Welcome back. So in this video, I will be doing another day in the life of a mom of seven. So I started letting my 12-year-old do her own hair. It's impossible, cause I want your love around no matter the cost. My heart all in pieces, I lost what I needed, my God, hate this feeling. I had to brush my boy's hair. On all or nothing, moving on is boring. We say goodbye, and it's killing us. Looking like two J-Ray, falling off the tracks. We were fine, so I mess it up. I don't know, don't know, don't know. We say goodbye, and it's not for us. Feeling like we lost it, never out of touch. We rebound, and it's all because we don't know, don't know, don't know how to let go. Some reward points on my IHOP app, so I end up getting the boys pancakes. Yeah, the people that I work with tell you I ain't never just go off on people for no reason. Like, you gotta get like real smart with me for me to like, okay, look, no, we not doing this. You're not gonna talk to me like that. Sorry. Just because I work in here don't mean you're going to talk to me like that. Because people come in talking any kind of way and it makes no sense. No sense. No, we're not doing it. But yeah, we had one girl up in McDonald's that I go some man time. He was going to do something to her. Some homeless guy said he was going to do something to her or something. She done called her whole family up there. They up there going off on the man, followed him to the bus stop. He gets on the bus and the dudes that she called up there, they done jumped on him. Whooped his tail at the bus stop. So, I ain't never took that far. Yeah, so one time I was working and the homeless guy, it was a homeless guy in there. And I don't know, he always was in there asking people to buy him food. Breakfast, lunch, dinner. He was always in there asking people to buy him food. So one time, something was going on with his drink or something. I don't know. Anyway, so, no. His sandwich wasn't right. The way he wanted his sandwich wasn't right. So the manager was trying to explain to somebody else about the sandwich or something. The dude took and threw the drink on the manager. The manager took the broom. He took the broom and beat the man all the way out the door. The part that you sweep with flew off, and he in the parking lot, they fighting, and he steady beating him with a broomstick. Y'all, I was working in them, this last one, I was working in the most ghettoest restaurant. Oh my gosh, this last McDonald's was so ghetto. I just seen one of my old employees. I was like, you still there? She was like, no. You still there? I said, no. We was like, yeah, because that place wasn't it. Because two dudes got to fighting in there. They supposed to be, one supposed to be making fries, the other one supposed to be making food in the kitchen. And they under their breath making some type of comments between each other and got to fight. And I'm like, why? Why? Can we just get along, please? Something like, I don't know. What can we do? Better. I'm like, no. I'm just ready to go. Yeah, these comments y'all be making be so pointless, because you you really making a comment to me, like the negative comments, you're making the comments and then I'm hiding you or removing the comment. I'm not even reading the whole thing. So what you're saying really is pointless. Like, I really don't care. But for all the positive comments that I get, or I'm not gonna say or, and I'm gonna say and the other comments that's, you know, telling me I can do things a certain way, like, long as it's in a positive way when you say it to me, like, I'm cool. I get a lot of positive comments on here. But yeah, the positive comments, like, I love them. I love to read them. I comment back if I know what to say. Like, sometimes I get some positive comments I don't really know what to say, but I'm going to heart it because you took your time out to comment to me to, you know, to say something positive to me. You ain't even say nothing mean. So I try to go through the comments and I try to answer and say things. Somebody just told me I should take down my video of how I lost my Section 8. And I feel like I shouldn't. I do feel like the video was a little bit all over the place. But I was trying to make sure I, like, answered everything. Because, you know, some people were saying that, because I said I was going to do a video instead of doing it live. And it was like, well, you're not going to answer all the questions or something. I don't know. They would just be saying stuff. So I was just trying to make sure I answered everything. Like I said before, like, I know my apartment could have been clean. I should have put the kids to work, but let me tell you something. That's why I say I want my kids to have a backyard, because why? When they go in the backyard, they can go in the backyard and make that mess. But yeah, this new place, it's gonna be different. Like, I can't, because I already know that with the house being messed up like it was, like, that was messing with my mental, like, that messed with my anxiety and my depression. Like, that made me depressed, because, you know, your surroundings, if it's cluttered, your mind is cluttered. And that was always, my mind was always cluttered. Like, getting off work and have to come home and clean, like, that was just a lot. That's why when me and my daughter worked at the same McDonald's, I didn't, when we got off, I told her, you go ahead to bed. I'm not about to sit here and make you clean, for one, and not your kids, for two, you didn't do it. That's my job. So I always stuck with that. It was a lot of times that I stayed up and cleaned, even though I had a whole babysitter there to watch them, and they wasn't doing what they supposed to do. And that's my fault, because after the first time, I should have took the hint and just went, nah, I gotta get somebody else to watch my kids. November, my baby turns, my oldest daughter turns 17.
My God.
And I still treat her like a baby. She turned 17. It's crazy. I feel old. I gotta figure out what I want to do for her birthday. And my baby want to get her nails done. She don't never want to get her nails done. Well, she don't never want to get her nails done. But I have talked her into doing it twice. So I've gotten her nails done twice. And so we are going to get her nails done. I'm gonna see if she let me make her nails. Y'all know how people be getting the press on nails and stuff. I'm gonna see if she'll let me make her nails. Cause I can go and get all the stuff from Dollar Tree and make her nails. Because my cousin, she used to make nails. She made them for my sister. Y'all too. Y'all, these two stay at it all the time. But then when one leaves the other, they have no fit. I don't understand. But anyway, so yeah, my cousin used to do them. She did it for my sister. She did it for my sister's prom, I think. She did her press on nails. And they were cute. So I was thinking about, I'm going to see if she let me do it. I'm going to do like a,
Let's go to daycare.
Daycare?
Yeah.
No, you don't go to daycare. You're in school. Huh? And I always want you out of school because you had a fever this morning. He had a fever of 100, and he is, like, not even hot now. Like, it just went away. I gave him some Tylenol this morning before we left my mom's house, and he's not even hot no more. But, yeah. Ooh, that's going to be fun. So, I'm a DoorDash today, and I'm going to get the money, and I'm going to go to Dollar Tree and get the supplies, and I'm gonna make like a practice set. Depressed lately, like this whole situation is depressing, but I could sit here and do something for my baby, for one of my babies. Like, I try to do something for all my babies all the time, because I'm not the only one going through this situation. My husband not the only one going through this situation. My kids are also going through this situation. So I try to do things with them. That's why I go into the park a lot. Like, before we had a place, we barely went to the park. But now, like, they asked to go to the park, we do the park. We've done walking around the mall, whether we can't shop or not, but it's got like a little play area in the mall, or just walking around and looking. They like doing that stuff too. Going to the playground, the McDonald's playground, I take them to do that. That way I can edit a video, or I can get some clips for a video, you know, let them play and stuff like that. Like, I try to keep the kids busy as much as possible. I try for us to stay away from my mom's house. Not like trying to sit in the mean way, but like, when we stayed at my husband's sister's house, you know, we stayed gone. I try to do the same thing now. That way they're not getting fussed about everything. Like, me and my mom sitting here had a talk yesterday, or day before yesterday, because I packed the kids up and was like, let's go. I left my oldest daughter there because she wasn't feeling well, but I just packed water. I mean, not packed them up, but we left. And she was like, where y'all going? I said, I don't know, just somewhere, just out, like out of the house. Like, and then when I came back, she was talking to somebody on the phone. Mom, I think she was talking to my dad. And he wanted her to cook, and she was like, she ain't feel like cooking. So he's like, tell Scott to cook. And he's like, she was like, I'm not about to ask her. She in one of her moves. And I'm like, I'm not in one of my moves. What are you talking about? She's like, yes, you are. You left out of here mad. And I'm like, Mom, because you sitting here saying that the bathroom smell like pee, that the second bathroom smell like pee, because she where? Stop. Right, right. Sit down. JC, stop being mean. Mm-hmm. Like, she got two bathrooms in her house. One, she is only for her. She calls it her bathroom. Like, even my dad can't use it. I mean, you can use it if you got pee, but it's like emergency, like you got pee real bad. But as in, everybody use the bathroom? No. So I was just like, Mom, you say the bathroom smell like pee, and it's like you're trying to blame just my kids. She said, no, I'm blaming all the boys, because all the boys need the aim, including mine. She said, I'm telling all of them. Like, I'm like, Mom, I said like that, you making it seem like. But she really was like, because she just kept repeating it. So I don't know. It's just like, I'm not. But all right, y'all. So my husband's back. Oh, so now we got to go do something.
Spend my money.
Spend my money.
No, Jason.
Yeah, go down some now, I think. Right? I think it's right there.
Right here?
Yeah, it should be. Yeah, it should be right there.
It is not for you.
No,
Nana
has the purple
one.
Oh,
yeah, they got
Nana.
That one now.
Nana. I want this one.
No, not that one.
They got this one.
This one right here.
No, she's not getting that either.
Why?
I don't like that.
What about this?
What? What about this?
They got that one.
What about this?
Oh, yeah, those.
What about this?
Bobo.
Like Maya, like bubble tea.
What about this one?
Get her one.
What about this one?
Get Maddie one.
Can I get this one?
No, Maddie got a lip gloss.
Can I get this one?
What about this?
That's red. That's color. Get clear.
Well, Mom.
Why do you need to wear color? Get clear.
Color. You don't like color.
No, I don't like color. Yeah, you need clear.
I need this. What about this? This is
what is that? That's not. Is it clear? Do you see clear? I don't like
it's
color.
You want to go back old school?
Oh, a blending. That is cool. Here.
I bet you it's so good.
No, do you see one yet?
No, man.
So you don't want the bubble tea one?
You want this one?
Mama said no color.
No color. Hold on. Let go, boys. Let me see.
Yeah, they do.
So they can make
color. I think this is
it.
Yeah, I think this is color. No, it's not. It's not clear.
What about this one?
That is
not color.
Some type of color in there. That ain't.
No, it looks clear.
Clear. Clear. Clear.
Clear.
Clear.
My hood.
I know, I see it. Clear.
Oh, look, it's clear. It's good stuff out there.
That's like a crystal color.
Mama, that is sparkle. You added sparkle to me.
Mom, this don't look.
Cool. What's in here? These are lip gloss, but they still got color. I don't feel like an 8-year-old should wear color. Okay, you can pick one of these, I guess. This time, and I'm gonna tell you now, if it looks grown, you're not wearing it no more. So if you wanna waste your dollar on this, I see it. Put it back. If you wanna waste your dollar on this, look clear. Ooh, they got the pink one and the purple one in bubble tea. Maya don't really like neither one, so one is blueberry scented, one is strawberry scented.
No, it's any
mini. What in the world is this?
Hold it. Hold it. DJ, excuse me. Like, this is what I mean by clear. Clear. Ooh, Fruity Pebbles. Fruity Pebbles.
Yeah,
this is for girls.
It's for oil for your lips. It's oil for your lips.
No, but it's for girls.
How is that for girls if it's oil for your lips?
Because it is. It's not for boys.
Mom.
It's not for boys. It's not for boys. It's not for boys. Ooh, look at this eyelash glue.
Your daughter did.
I dropped it in there.
Oh my god. It's eyelash fast drying.
I was trying to do it. It dropped
in
there.
Look at these.
That's not even.
Ooh. Yeah. You can get
these.
Look at these.
Whoa, I did not see this. Why would we pass these ones?
I don't know. I like this one.
You like that one?
Cinderella, yeah.
I want
which one you like? You want that one?
You gonna go back to the car.
Ooh. Yes. Detangling brush. Because ours got destroyed in the back of the van. Let me see. Is this the one I want to do? This one. I like this one.
What
should I do this one?
Ooh, this one. That one I can brush his hair.
My wood.
What?
My wood.
Oh, look, Mama.
What is that? That's supposed to make the
amazing.
All right, y'all. Look what I found at Dollar Tree. Oh, my gosh. I needed these so bad. My feet are still swollen, so I am definitely about to put these on.